React and Hadoop are quite different data platforms. Hadoop is designed to process large amounts of data at scale when a single interaction with data usually involves scanning a huge amount of data to deliver the end result to the end user or whoever is requesting those results. Or you're ingesting a very large amount of data at the same time or in a sort of streaming, constantly ingesting fashion. While React, on the other hand, while it can process large amounts of data, it can store large amounts of data, each interaction with React data store is usually pretty small and narrow, right? With, you know, one key value or record or a few of those, and you're looking up only a few records at a time generally. So that's where React really designed for. So it can power your website, for example. It can store your comments of your website or some stuff of your social media systems. It can be a place which runs some audit for what type, part of the program applications you're accessing, or providing certain authentication authorization lookup services when you need to have sort of few milliseconds response time and you need to be very high, very fault tolerant, very sort of highly available system, and you can deal with certain compromises in terms of whether performance or data integrity and data consistency in a React cluster. So that's where React shines. And Hadoop is actually the system that would process data like React collecting, right? If you're collecting certain OD data about which components of your systems are using or which API calls you are doing and you store it in React, Hadoop is a system which can actually then analyze, process this data and get some insights out of it. So you could actually see React and Hadoop sometimes working together when Hadoop is actually ingesting data off React, so using it as one of its, you know, various data sources. So that's how you kind of can see those together. But other than that, they are quite different systems built for different purposes.